Typically speaking, stocks offer higher risk and higher potential return than fixed income. But it is possible to find exceptions to this general rule. Let's take a look at two different companies. Company A is a large national bank that is known for being very conservative. Every year, they seem to grow revenues by about 5% like clockwork. Their stock fluctuates, but doesn't seem to fluctuate as much as the overall market. This would be known as a low beta stock. There's also little expectation that this company would run into any significant issues. Company B is a smaller technology company that is launching a new smartphone to compete with the industry giants. They've been plagued with high company turnover, the CEO has been replaced 3 times in the last 5 years, and they've just raised money by issuing bonds offering to pay 15% interest per year for the next 5 years so they can build a new factory. Analysts think the new phone will flop and the stock price has been dropping. The very fact that the interest rate being offered is so high is because no one would buy their bonds if they offered a lower interest rate. The company is just seen as too risky, and potential bond owners want to be compensated for taking the added risk of investing in these bonds. If the company manages to be moderately successful, then the bondholders will get the high interest rate due on these bonds. But if the company does poorly and can't pay the interest, the bond's value would trade at a discount, meaning that they can be sold, but at a cheaper price than their original face value. If the company goes under, the bondholders may only get pennies on the dollar for their investments. This is just an example to demonstrate that you always have to remember that risk and return are related. If a bond, traditionally viewed as a more conservative investment, is offering a very high interest rate, then you know it's because there is more risk.